So we enter data in QM for Windows. And we are doing this for project management. And this is cost budgeting. We have A, B, C, D, E, F, G, 7 activities. So we can say 7. And OK. So activity times that we have is 8, 4, 3, 5, 6, 5, 3. Cost we have is 8,000. 1,000, 6, so the first one we have is for C, which is A, and then we have B, then we have C and D, same thing C and D. So once the data is entered, now we can solve this. So after solving, you can see that activities A, activities C, F, and G have 0 slack. So that means they are on the critical path. So we can make that out from this also. What else? We get from this analysis, apart from all these timings like early start time, early finish, late start and late finish, we get. So we have two charts, one based on early starting times and the other one is based on late start times. What you get here is based on the plan. Activity A, for activity A, we have to spend $1,000 in period 1, $1,000 in period 2. So for first 8 periods, we have to spend $1,000 each. So this is what we have. If you look at, for A, the time is 8 and the cost is 8,000 total. So this 8,000 is spread over as 1,000 for each period. So 8,000 divided by 8 is 1,000. So that 1,000 gets spread over 8,000, 8 periods. Similarly, B, if you look at B, it will need 4 time periods and the total cost is 12,000. So 12 divided by 4 is 3,000. So each period, 3,000 will have to be spent on activity B. So that's what you see here. So in 4 periods, in each period you get 3,000 each, so that the total is 12,000. So this is repeated for each activity and then you get a total of the cost for period 1. So 1,000 plus 3,000 is 4,000 and so on. So for example, in period 17, 1,500 plus 2,000 is 3,500. And last row is cumulative first time period. So first number remains as it is 4,000. Then you add this 4 to the earlier 4,000, you get 8,000. Again, add 4, you get 12,000 and so on. So the total budget in this case is $66,000. Now you can look at any time period. For example, by the end of time period 10, you would expect to spend about $39,000. Based on this chart, cost using early start times $39,000. So if we go back to the chart, and I will minimize this and open the second table. So this is based on latest start times. So you'll notice that the total after 95 period is 66,000. So the total amount of money that will be spent on the project is going to remain same. If you look at period number 10, so you see 36,000. by the end of month 10, you should have spent about $36,000 if you do the calculation. So I'm just using one example of month number 10. So if at the end of 10 months, the reality is that the team has spent, let's say, $45,000. I'm just using a hypothetical number. So 45,000 is obviously outside this range of 36,000 and 39,000. So that means the project is going over budget and there's need for bringing it back within project budget. Similarly, if you find that at the end of 10 months, you have spent about $37,000. So then you compare that with these two numbers and you'll find that we are going with the project within budget. So this is good, but this is not good. So this table basically helps to figure that out, that whether we are within the planned budget cost or we are exceeding it, so that we need to take some corrective action. So this analysis and these tables are useful monitoring how much spending is being done in each time period and whether any corrective action is needed if we are going over budget. The word crashing does not mean that how to crash the project. It simply means if we want to complete a given and well-planned project in less time, let's say making that house instead of 16 weeks, somebody says that we are ready to spend more money. Can we do it in 14 weeks? So a project can be always completed earlier if there are more resources. So if you put more people to work and you have sufficient resources, you can always do it in less time. But obviously it will cost more because you have to hire more people to work parallelly on certain activities. So it is possible, but at a cost. So how to do that? How to choose like which activity we can crash? Crash means we can do in less time, spending some more money. It has to be done judicially. We cannot take any activity and just put more people to work and expect to complete the project. We have to take into account how we can put more resources at the same time we minimize the total cost, total expected cost. So although we'll be spending more, but that more should be as less as possible given the situation. So for this I'm going to use data from problem number 30 and 31 from the book. So I'll use that data. Crash cost per week for activity A. So to do this calculation, because we have this crash cost and the which is over and above the regular cost. So for the first one, we do 9800 minus 8000. So this difference divided by the difference in the times, so 3 minus 2. So this gives us 1800. So that's what we can put here by taking into account the extra cost and time. Now choosing like which activities can be crashed or where we can spend more money and get it done in less time. So logically, obviously, we should crash an activity which is on the critical path, because if you try to do certain activity which is not on the critical path in less time, it has no impact on the total time. It will not reduce the total project completion time. So only if we reduce activity time of an activity which is on the critical path, we can reduce the total time. So that's why we have to figure out which are the activities that are on the critical path and then the choice will be out of that. Other we can rule out. So to find activity on the critical path, we have to make the chart again. So start. So that 8 goes to both these nodes. 8 minus 5 is 3. So between 3 for E and 4 for C, 3 is the lower. So we get 3 and 0 completes that loop. 6 minus 4 is 2. So this is what we get. Now if you look for critical path, so the choice is out of these four, and obviously it makes sense that we look for the lowest crash cost per week. So in this column, only looking at the activities which are on critical path, you get the lowest value as $700. So if you want to complete, and please note that this activity G, which will take regularly like 4 weeks, now it can be done in 2 weeks. So you can reduce the total time by maximum 2 weeks here. If you want to still reduce it further, obviously you'll have to make another chart again, look at the critical path once again, and then make a choice based on crash cost per week. The answer is going to be, will crash activity G based on this analysis. Note that activity D crash cost per week is $500, which is even lower than 700, but it will not help because it is not on critical path. By crashing activity D, you are not going to save the total completion time in any way. So that's why it is important we only look at activities on the critical path. One situation could be, like you have seen earlier also, here we have one critical path, only one critical path, but there could be a situation where you have more than one critical path. So if there are two critical paths and you want to crash the project by putting extra resources at certain activities, then we should choose an activity is on both critical paths. So that way we can make sure that we can reduce the time, and also with minimum extra cost we can complete it earlier.